Hey friends, did you know that you can now run high-scale load tests in the Azure portal? While the test is running, you'll get live updates of client and server-side metrics. John Stallo is here to introduce me to the new Azure load testing service today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. Today I'm going to learn all about Azure load testing. Talking with John Stallo, how are you, sir?
Hi Scott, thank you for having me on.
Thanks for dialing in from Perth. Lovely Western Australia. We appreciate you either staying up or getting up early. I have no idea what time it is there.
It's early in the morning and it's going to be a hot day.
Brilliant, brilliant. So, you know, the great thing about load testing and using something like this in Azure and the cloud is that not only do you have infinite scale, but you can have that load come from anywhere in the world. So I suppose that you could test my website from there or I could test yours from there. We have a lot of choice, don't we?
Indeed, indeed. And Azure Load Testing is a new service that is really designed to help developers and testers gain confidence in their application's performance and ability to meet demand.
That is a really great point. You know, very, very often we don't trust our machines. And the whole point of testing, whether it be unit testing or integration testing or load testing, is to have a feeling of like, yeah, you know, I trust that this is going to do well on Black Friday or whenever I go and launch these things.
That's right. You know, that confidence that I was talking about can come in many forms. You know, one is that important event like Black Friday, tax season, where your application needs to be ready right from the get-go. But it can also be like earlier in the development lifecycle. It might be that you're working on, you know, redesigning your architecture. You might be taking a new dependency, using an Azure service for the first time. And that could also be while you're in the thick of it and you want to really want to make sure that you're that you're able to catch and block performance regressions as soon as they happen. And so we see a lot of teams interested in how can they automate load tests in their deployment pipeline.
You know, that is a really great point. You know, back in the day, 15 plus years ago, even 20 years ago, for us, the load testing was an event that happened at the end of the waterfall. And we would all get, okay, here we're going to do it. We're doing the load test this week. It's going to be a big deal. But you're describing that this can be a part of that shift left experience. And there's no reason I can't be load testing, you know, every CI/CD pipeline and making sure that that's part of that pipeline. And then with the right metrics, make educated decisions about whether or not something regressed or something got better.
That's right. You know, so, you know, teams are definitely deploying a lot more often nowadays. And so you really want to have that confidence during your development lifecycle. And it really starts with being able to simulate your load in a real traffic, in a real world way, and then be able to learn how your application behaves under stress.
Okay. Do you have a demo where you can show me how easy this is?
I'd love to show you how easy it is to get started, and then we can look into a little, a few more features.
All right, let's do it.
Okay, so you know, Azure Load Testing is available right in the portal. I think I mentioned that it's in public preview right now. We just launched last December, so we're pretty excited about it. But to get started, I can go and create a resource. And then I just search for Azure Load Testing. And then I'm ready to get going and I'm on my way. When you create an Azure Load Testing resource, what it basically is a way for you to be able to manage your tests. And you could also manage access to who can actually run the load test, who can actually access the results. I'm going to go ahead and create my own test here. Mm-hmm. Let's give it a name. And then in my test plan, I'm going to upload a JMeter script. Now, JMeter is a very popular open source load testing framework. It has a lot of extensibility built in, a lot of enterprise-friendly features, and it has a great community. So it's really easy to be able to go out and get help, get resources about how to configure a good load test. Yeah. And then with Azure Load Testing, that's basically it. I've uploaded my JMeter script and I'm ready to go. There's a lot of other things you could do about it, mm-hmm. Do with it. But maybe just one of the things to point out is if you're wanting to scale out and be able to simulate high traffic, it's as easy as just being able to use a slider, be able to increase the number of parallel engine instances.
You know, it's really great. I'm just going to go ahead and, if I may, it's a really great point that it's JMeter, because JMeter is a very mature open source project. Apache JMeter has been around since the SOAP web services days. And when we say test something, we're not talking about just sending a bunch of HTTP gets at an endpoint. You can test web services. You can test FTP. You can test specific TCP things. You can do native command. Like JMeter is really powerful, and you're doing JMeter in the cloud, which is going to enable people who have existing JMeter tests to be really successful. But if someone is just getting into JMeter, they're going to be really impressed with the amount of flexibility. That plus the infinite scale of the cloud is really powerful.
Indeed, indeed. So what I've done here is I've actually kicked off that load test. Mm-hmm. It's going to, actually it's already started to execute, and I'll start seeing some results already show up in real time in the chart in the second. Mm-hmm. And the other important thing is, like, at any time that I want, I can actually just stop my load test, just in case, you know, things are going wrong and I really want to be able to just put, you know, everything on pause. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, you can see that as that load test is actually running, I can see that, you know, slowly I am ramping up the mm-hmm. load that is being sent to my application. You know, I can see other important metrics that JMeter provides, like response time and request per second. So far, it seems like it's kind of holding steady. I'm not seeing any errors yet.
Mm-hmm. Looks like a bit of a cold start there. You started at about 2 seconds, and it kind of like warmed up very quickly. Right. Maybe it's caching some stuff. You can really understand. The fact that it's happening in real time is really cool. Like, I'm watching it update every few seconds with real-time information. And right now on that response time, those averages are high only because the first one was at 2.5 seconds. But it looks like you're under a fifth of a second there. Little hiccup there. Something just happened. Oh, wow.
Yeah, something happened here. And I'm actually now starting to see some errors come in.
Look at that.
And I've actually hit my peak load here. Hmm. And so as that's being sustained, I can see my application, you know, is it going to be able to, you know, handle that? Is it going to get back on track?
Uh-oh.
And it's still, yeah, so something's not going quite right. So, like, even here, I can already learn about how my application behaves under certain load. Right? You know, we saw it was behaving okay, like earlier on.
Yeah.
But at this time now, things are definitely not going as we would want it.
Oh, wow. Okay. Yeah, looking great. You were doing a great job. The left side request per second was heading up towards 200, and then just something hiccuped, and now it's stumbled, and it doesn't seem to be able to write itself. And we've learned that just in a few seconds here by firing off this test in the cloud.
That's right. That's going to keep on going. So I'm going to just switch over to a load test that I had previously run on the same application. Mm-hmm. And you can kind of see the same pattern here that we had seen, you know, before. Everything seemed to be going right with response times. I wasn't getting any errors. But then at some point, as I was hitting peak load in my load test, then I start to see those really long response times and errors. Mm-hmm. And so this is what we call client-side metrics. This is everything that JMeter is telling me about how my application is, you know, is running from a black box perspective, you know, from a, you know, as users going to my application, they're bound to see some of these response times and bad errors. But one of the immediate questions then that one would have when you run a load test like this is, well, then how did my application components actually behave during the load test? And this is where we can really take advantage that Azure load testing is an Azure service. So it really is optimized for applications that are hosted in Azure. And so now I can actually go ahead and add what we call server-side metrics. My application here is made up of, you know, an API that is actually deployed to app service. It talks to a backend database. And so I can go ahead and click on configure app components. And then here I can just go off and you know, filter by you know, different resource groups and subscriptions and so mm-hmm. forth. I know that my target application, the application that I was testing, is actually deployed to this resource group. And I can see here I've got an app service plan. It's talking to Cosmos DB. I actually using application insights for telemetry. So it's easy as just selecting these resources and then add those to my dashboard.
Interesting. So you've got what you're calling client-side metrics. That's kind of the pane of glass. That's from the point of view of there's an endpoint out there, and I'm going to poke at that endpoint, and this is what I'm seeing on this side. And then now that you've got you're introspective, you're able to introspect into those server-side components.
That's right.
You're going to be able to see all of the other side once you've come inside the cloud, what's happening.
Exactly. And so you can see that I'm getting, some insight into in my app service, where my API is hosted, you know, what my CPU and memory looked like. And that seemed to be okay. But as I scroll down, I can actually now also start to see some other... some other metrics that, you probably already saw it here. Cosmos DB, I'm already maxing out my IU consumption. So there's something here that's telling me about maybe the way that my Azure resource is configured, or the way that I'm using it is maybe surprising, and that's why I'm actually seeing these results.
This is so significant for people who may have been in the industry for a very long time. If you do a front-end load test against a website and the website has a data structure, a data source, SQL Server downstream, you're going to see that present itself as 500 errors, so on the glass, HTTP 500 is going to go up.
Then
to figure out that it wasn't the web server or the load balancer or the reverse proxy, it's downstream, could take you days. We would go digging through log files for days to try to figure out the kind of insights that you've already figured out in 5 minutes of using Azure load testing with that server-side component.
That's right. I can even actually click into these metrics. And so we're pulling in metrics from all over Azure Monitor, Container Insights, if I was using Kubernetes Service, Application Insights. In this case, I've actually drilled into the requests that are reaching my backend database. And then I can just poke around. Here I can see that out of all the requests being sent to my database, I can actually see that my database is now throttling. And that's why now that's having that end-to-end errors that I'm seeing then in my front-end API. Because of what's happening in my backend database.
So in this case, we've learned that 100 users at the website perspective, at the JMeter user test perspective, is going to equal more RUs, more resource units from the Cosmos perspective than we are prepared to offer. Forgive my ignorance, but would you be able to then scale Cosmos and put in more RUs, and this would be a successful test?
Absolutely. And so then Cosmos actually enables a lot of really good ways to scale, including being able to also configure it for auto scale. In fact, one of the things that maybe I could show you is after having run this load test for some time, I had some hypotheses about maybe what I could do to actually improve my Cosmos scale. And so just now being able to compare results is as easy as selecting these test runs and compare them. And then that would actually then give me confidence of whether any of these changes that I made to my application or my configuration actually improved my my application's performance. In this case, you can see that if I can just maybe filter down to one metric at a time, you can see after making those changes, my response time actually was healthy after making the improvements to my backend database. I no longer saw any errors to compare that very first load test that we saw that we were getting lots of errors there. So really, load testing is really there to be able to help you run these real world simulations and then gain that confidence about how to improve your application's performance.
That is brilliant. That is brilliant. So there are folks that are watching right now who may have JMeter tests. They can bring those up into Azure load testing. There may be people who are just getting started with load testing, but they have existing resources in Azure. This is going to be a very nice complement. I'm thinking already about how I could possibly put this in my own CI/CD pipeline and run this as an epilogue to, like, I've done my unit test, I've done my smoke test, maybe I've done my Playwright functional testing. Now I'm going to go and do some JMeter stress tests. So for example, I just upgraded from .NET 5 to .NET 6. I don't really know whether it got better or not from a load testing perspective. Now I can.
Awesome. I'm looking forward to, you know, what, you know, how customers use this. We're here in public preview. We want to learn how to make this better and more useful for developers and testers to gain their confidence. One last thing, maybe just to point anyone who's interested in giving this a try. We have a great documentation hub where there's quick starts, but there's also a lot of really good end-to-end tutorials about some of the features that I showed, but also being able to automate your load tests in, say, your GitHub workflow, your Azure DevOps pipeline. All of those really good scenarios are all right here in documentation page.
Fantastic. I'm going to go check that out. Continuous regression testing. That is exactly what I want. I want to watch for any performance regressions or performance improvements, and now I can do it with Azure load testing. Thank you so much, John Stallo.
Thank you, Scott. Thank you.
All right. I am learning all about how to make my sites scale even better with Azure load testing today on Azure Friday. Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.